Good evening, or good afternoon, depending on where you're watching this video from. Robert Dunbar here, Training by Dunbar, wanting to come back for part two of Mindset is Everything. Part two, Mindset is Everything. So it seems like I'm going to be doing more than two parts because there's a lot more information to give you all, a few more homework assignments. So I'm going to move on forward with this for as long as it takes me to complete this topic. And really, you know, this is something that can help you no matter where you're at in your business, in your life. And this is not only for you. So what do I mean by that? I'm pretty transparent. I do these videos to help as many people as possible, but it's also helping me in the completion of my book because some of these things I'm talking about, I'm finishing up chapters that I can utilize this material for. So I will be using this for that as well. So taking this information in for yourself will help you build in the space you're building in. It'll help me complete my book. So for those that don't know, my book that'll be coming out, it'll be coming out next year, 2020, Becoming an Entrepreneur in the Network Marketing Industry. And I'm going to be covering a lot of different topics, and I'll talk about that at another time. Right now, I'm going to get into this video because I'm only doing short 10-minute videos. So yesterday, I asked you all to do a homework assignment. What was the homework assignment? To look in your phone, see who your contacts are. Who are you spending time with? Who are you spending time with on social media? Whose material are you looking at? What pages do you follow? What are your friends saying on your page that's capturing your attention? I ask you to do that because I want you to see what you're putting in front of your face, because that controls your mindset. So I hope you all have done that. If you haven't done it, whenever you do it and you watch this video, which is part two, you will see what to do with it. So what I want you to start doing is limiting how much you take in of things that aren't benefiting you in the goals that you're looking to hit. Meaning that you're looking to move forward in your business, you're looking to move forward in your life. It doesn't matter whether you're looking to get married. It doesn't matter whether you're looking to build a business. It doesn't matter whether you're looking to get promoted in a job that you work at currently. You can have goals in any of those positions, and you still have to set your mind to do those things. And I need you all to have a vision board. I need you all to keep your goals in your face. And I need you to start training your brain to move forward in what you're wanting to do here in the future. So limiting the people that you talk to. And this can be difficult for some of you all who have friends and family who aren't really assisting you in moving forward. Now, I'm not saying that they should be doing things to help you move forward. What I'm saying is the content that you take in from them, if it's not taking you, moving you forward in your process, then it's not assisting you, and you're taking in information that's training your brain to do something different, especially if most of the information you're taking in is not things that you're using to move forward in the area that you're looking forward to move into. So let me explain to you what I mean. If you're saying, you know, I want my business to go to the next level. So I'm doing $100,000 a year and I want to get myself to $250,000 a year. Or I'm at $250,000 a year, I'm looking to get to $500,000 a year. Well, you need to be surrounding yourself with people who have already advanced in that space, or who are advancing in that space the same time you are, so that you guys can feed off of each other. You can watch the mistakes that they make, vice versa, and you can have conversations with people who have already made the mistakes to get to that $500,000, and you can ask them questions. If that's where you're looking to go, and that's just an example, right? If that's where you're looking to go, then you don't want to be spending your time around people who make less than $100,000 a year. You don't want to spend your time having conversation with people on Facebook, Instagram, different social media sites who are making less than that, because they're not helping you get to where you're going, because the content that you take in from them are setting you back as opposed to moving you forward. So let's talk about two things here. Got a couple flashcards. I'll try to keep some flashcards so you guys can see some things. So you've got something called a fixed mindset. And you've got something called a growth mindset. Growth mindset was actually coined by a young lady. I believe her name is Carol Dweck. Carol Dweck, you can find her on YouTube. She's got a few books and things like that. And she talks about growth mindset. So you need to find out whether you have a fixed mindset or a growth mindset. And once you figure that out, you need to move in that space. So right now, You've looked at your phone. You've looked at your social media. You've looked at your companionships and people that you're spending time with, a one-on-one or groups that you hang out with. And I'm not saying you can't go have fun with your friends. What I'm saying is keep in front of your brain, in front of your eyes, in front of your mind. Keep in front of you the things that are helping you build forward in your dreams and in your goals. Because if you don't, you start to confuse your brain. If you say, I'm looking to get to $250,000, or I'm looking I've been dating a long time and I'm looking to get married, but you're hanging around single people. If you're looking to get married and you're serious about meeting somebody and getting married, right? Then you need to hang around married people. You need to spend your time having conversations with men and women that are married, because now you're training your brain to take in the content that you need to understand how to be a good husband or wife. Does that make sense? Why do I use that example? Because I want people to understand that setting your mind to do better things is not just about growing a business. I want you to hear this information, no matter what you're setting as a positive goal for yourself. Setting your mind works in all those aspects. It's not just about making more money. It's about being a better parent. It's about being a better spouse. It's about being a better friend, brother, sister, uncle, mother, daughter, whatever you need to be. So set these things in your face. So we want to slow down on talking to people, texting people, being on social media, in a space where it's not moving towards those goals. So if you're going to be on social media, find you some groups to get in that are maybe some workshops that people are doing that create income, or maybe some mastermind groups where they're talking about earning more money if that's what you're looking to do. If you're a single dad or a single mom, you say, I want to be the best mom I can as a single mom, then find some groups on Facebook or some videos on YouTube that train you on how to be a good mother. That's what you should do with your... So what are you doing? You're replacing this time you're spending on television watching Lifetime or watching episodes of Empower or Power, Empire or Power, whatever it is that people watch. I don't watch a lot of television. I'm just kind of going off of what I've heard. Whatever you're watching on TV, replace that time with something that you can do that moves you in the direction of your goals and trains your brain so that you can get out of that fixed mindset and into a growth mindset. A growth mindset means that until the day you die, you can keep on learning more, growing more, educating yourself. They said people who drive cabs, Uber drivers, Lyft drivers, yellow cab drivers, that their brain is almost always on growth mindset in the space of them driving a vehicle, because they're always trying to find a new way to get to places, because they're picking up people and they want to find the fastest way so they can be the most efficient way that people get places so they'll get a call again. So just keep in mind, always working on your brain, always working on your brain. So substitute some of the relationships, some of the time that you're spending doing things that'll have you in a fixed mentality to a growth mentality. Now, for those that are thinking, I don't have a mentor, I don't have a bunch of intelligent friends that's moving in my direction, right now it's just me. I'm getting out this box. My family never grew a business. My family wasn't very successful. I've got some people around me that are kind of downers, and I want to be around some people who are more uplifting. Well, you will eventually find those people. I did a training in Maryland a couple of weeks ago, and I talked about, somebody asked me about a mentor. Well, where do I find a mentor? Because I want to get better. I need a mentor. Well, guess what? You don't find mentors. Mentors find you. You need to learn to be a good mentee. Once you learn how to be a good mentee, you will find mentors. So what do you do in the meantime when you're saying, well, I want to get better? That's not fair for me. Somebody, I have to wait for somebody to find me. So how do I work on getting better? Well, guess what? YouTube, Facebook, there's automatic mentors in those places. You've got video mentors. So what do? If you're a religious person and you want to get better in your religion, then go to videos on religion. Look for pastors that are talking about the things you want to hear. If you're a Muslim, if you're in yoga or meditating, find videos that talk about yoga and meditating and learn there. Once you start practicing those things to get better, once you start arriving at places where people do those things and working around those people, you'll find a mentor, because the mentor will seek you out because they see that you're serious about moving in a direction in that space. So go to YouTube if you're saying, I'm looking to build, I want to go from $100,000 to $250,000. I want to go from $250,000 to $500,000. If that's what you want to do, then seek videos out that'll show you how to do that. How to become the next millionaire. Put things in there, books on building my business, becoming an entrepreneur. Find things like that and listen to those, because that is going to be your mentor, your video mentor, until a real mentor finds you as a mentee. So start changing your mindset now. Tomorrow, I'll be doing another video, which will be part 3 on Mindset is Everything. I hope you guys are gathering something out these videos. I look forward to seeing you guys on my next video shoot, Robert Dunbar Training by Dunbar.